Matthew 10. Can we start reading from verse 16? Verse number 16, because of our time. Verse 16. Are you there? Said, behold, I send you forth as sheep in the midst of wolves. Be ye therefore wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Verse 17. But beware of men, for they will deliver you up to their councils, and they will scourge you in their synagogues. Verse 18. And it shall be brought, and ye shall be brought before governors and kings for my sake, for a testimony against them and the Gentiles. Verse 19. But when they deliver you up, take no thought how or what ye shall speak, for it shall be given you in that same hour what ye shall speak. Verse 20. For it is not ye that speak, but the Spirit of your Father which speaketh in you. Verse 21. And the brother shall deliver up the brother to death, and the father the child, and the children shall rise up against their parents and cause them to be put to death. Verse 22. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. Can you read verse 22 in cross? One, two, go. And ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. Micah 7 verse 5. Hear this. If people hate you because of Christ, it's better. But if they hated you because of another thing, there is trouble. So if somebody hates you, you will ask, why do the person hated me? Is it because of Christ or because of something else? I'm seeing the glory of God dropping on your head. Micah 7 verse 5. I want us to read it together in cross. 1, 2, go. Trust ye not in a friend. Put ye not confidence in a guy. Keep the doors of thy mouth from air. The light in thy bosom. Bless the name of the word. Speak to us, Father. And let everyone here hear your words. Prepare everyone's hearts to receive directly from you. And use me as a vessel to speak to them. And after the message, let everyone go home being delivered, prosperous, and hope for function. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. Sit down, balance, touch your lips, and shake somebody left and right and say, you are going to manifest the glory of God. Can I talk to you here? Any true call or any genuine man that is genuine by God must have a Gehazi. If you are not genuine, if you are a genuine believer, you must have a Gehazi. If you don't have a Gehazi, it simply means you are not genuine. Amen. You want to do ministry, you want to start business, you want to work in an office, you are praying, Father, I want to be a manager or a director or chief director or chief executive director. And now God gave you the position. Genuinely, your certificate is not a fake certificate. You did not go to some place and say, forge certificate for me. Your certificate is genuine. I can tell you, you will see a Gehazi. The call of Joshua is a genuine call. Despite the promises of God, Gehazi show up. And if your vision is a true vision, and you know yourself that this vision was given to you by God, Get ready, because Gehazi of vision will come. If you don't want to fight for your position, I beg, don't ask God for position. Because every position attracts opposition. No opposition, no position. Can I talk to you? No matter how beautiful is your car, how expensive is your car, you will meet an ugly car on the road that can slow you down. So I'm trying to tell you, no matter how glorious you are, you will meet a man or a woman that will slow their glory down. But anytime you see that there is a space for you to overtake, don't stay behind. Overtake.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Are you getting me? These are the things that believer ignore. Believer thought that anytime you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, truly you are on expressway. But there are some people who call the same name Jesus you are calling, but not from heart. And you will meet them in the same road.
That's correct.
Every road, no matter how straight the road is, there must be either T junction or four junction.
Amen.
So when you get there, there is a junction of decision. So you will know exactly where you are going to, then you take the right place. Am I talking to you here? And that is why this morning I'm sharing with you on what I titled Beware of Men. Beware of men. Beware of men. Hear this. God is love. True of us. God is what? And love is God. God is love. And love is God. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. So Jesus came out of love. So, and Jesus himself is love, because he was in the paradise of love. Am I talking to you here? So now, if God is love, and we say God is in our midst, and we say that we are Christ-like and we are Christian, then automatically our name is supposed to be called love. You don't get what I'm saying here. If you carry the characteristics of God, then you want to be God on earth, according to the scripture. Before you can say you want to be God on earth, according to the scripture, you must understand who is God. You cannot resemble a father if you does not come out of the belly of the father. You don't get what I'm saying here. So if you say you have been washed by the blood, and the blood of Jesus have saved you, and now you are a believer, you are a Christian, then you must understand that you have carried the DNA of Jesus. And what is that DNA? It is the spirit of love. So if you are calling yourself a believer and you don't have heart to love, even though you said you know the Bible from Genesis to Revelation, I can tell you, you are going to hell. Am I talking to somebody here? Beware of men. Look at the scripture that we read. Oh my God. Look at the scripture that we read here. In the book of Matthew 10, verse 16, said, I am sending you out like a sheep among wolves. He said, therefore, be wise as what? As serpent, and harmless as dove. But, verse 17 said, but, there's a comma. He said, I am sending you out as a sheep in the midst of wolves. He said, be clever like what? Like serpent. And he said, be harmless like what? Like mean that be honest like a dove. The most honest animal on earth is dove. So be honest like a dove. And he said that even though I warn you or I send you, I said, but beware of what? Men. That statement is so deep. And that is where some believers have missing it. Can I talk to you?
The problem you are facing now, it is not God that caused it. It's a man like you. The level you are now, that you are struggling to move out of the level to a better level and live a better life, it is not God that hold you down, or it is not God that caused that stronghold or limitation. It's a man like you. It's a man like you. Anything you are looking for on earth, and you are asking God, Father, give me this, it's already been given the first day you ask. But because the act of men are full of evil from the days of their youth, so when they see that this thing will benefit you and this thing will move you to your next level, they hold it. Look at how many years have you been asking for promotion. So your promotion letter is in heaven. It's in the hand of who? Your boss. Your men. The day you pray, Father, I need promotion, God said, you qualify for it, approved. But a man like you hold it. I just want to give it out. So that is why I want you to understand something, that you must not ignore who is next to you and the character of those that are next to you. If you look at the word wolves, what is the spiritual meaning of wolves? Wolves simply means beware of witchcraft. You don't get what I'm saying here. I am sending you out on the assignment I give you. God cannot send a man out without an assignment. There is something that he has given unto you to come and manifest on earth. So he sends you out because there is something you need to do for him on earth. The way you are now, it is not because your father, your mother got married to one another that is the reason why you are here. You are here because heaven approved your coming to this world. And before heaven can approve something, you have been tested in heaven and trusted in heaven. You have been tested in heaven and trusted in heaven. Because God never created any man or woman to come to this world and fail. Because he created them in his own image. So once you represent the image of God, God will never send you to this world to come and be a liability or a waste. Am I talking to somebody here? So now, God said, as I'm sending you, I also send my only begotten son, which is Jesus Christ, to this world. I have foreseen all the things they have done to him. So now, you are going to earth, as you are going now somewhere, I tell you, beware of wolves. Who are the wolves? Witchcrafts. And who are witchcraft? Witches. They are like a spirit, but I can tell them it's a spirit of wickedness. So simply means, be aware that there are wicked people on earth. Can I talk to you here? If you are a believer and you are aware that there are wicked people on earth, any junction you get to and you meet any man, you will be able to cite the spirit of the man before you create a relationship with the man. The reason why your life is like this is because there are some people around you, you don't cite their spirit and you are giving them the syllabus of your function. When a teacher wants to teach a student, the number one thing they will give to the teacher is the syllabus. And what is the syllabus? The function of the student. The function of what they want to become in the school where they are, or institution where they are. So, if care is not taken, and you don't aware of what Jesus said, you will give the syllabus of your function to wolves without you knowing. How many glorious men here, as I'm talking to you now, how many glorious men, president of a nation, governor of a nation, prime minister of a nation, a financial apostle of a nation, that you are hearing me now, but you cannot manifest it because of what? You have opened up to those who hinder you. You have opened up. Can I talk to you here? As your heart is deep and it's very difficult for your friend to know, so also you yourself, when you want to deal with that person, be deep. Make sure that you don't allow that person to understand whom you are quickly. Am I talking to you here? There are some of you here, your life has become a vegetable in the hands of wolves. God in heaven will never come down to frustrate you. Those who are frustrating you are those who are around you. And somebody from Afghanistan cannot come and begin to frustrate you if the person doesn't have a relationship with you. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to someone here? Sometimes when you hear on your map, set, go, you are speeding. But some people have seen that your speed are too much for them, and they know that you are about to take the crown. They will cross your lane. How many of you that you start very well, you are doing extremely well, right from primary school, oh, excellent, secondary school, excellent, your parents have foreseen that, oh, we have a brilliant student here, a brilliant son, a brilliant daughter, that, oh, in future you're gonna be the joy of the family. But when you get to university, somebody that foresee the future in one way or the other cross you and introduce some kind of thing that will give that glory to you, and ignorantly you fall into it, and now you finish, nothing happened. Some of you drop out. Am I talking to somebody here? Know this from today, whether you are a professional or you are a businessman or you are a student or you are a pastor, if you are doing things genuinely, Gyasi must show up. No matter how good you are, you can never be good more than Jesus. No matter how better you are, you can never be best than Jesus. Jesus came to this world and still yet he faced challenges of humanity. He faces challenges of humanity. Jesus knew the heart of man. Anytime he spoke, and immediately he will interrupt them and say, I know what you are saying, this is what you are doing. He will quickly use his mouth to do what? To rescue himself and depart from the place. But look at you. Anytime you speak, you don't perceive that what have come out of your mouth have great enemies for your next level. Can I talk to you? Hear this today. The richest man on earth, you can never see him talking too much.
Amen.
They are a reserved person. And you can never hear them making glow, making noise. The media can quantify and release all the data of whatever they have, but you can never hear from their mouth. And any news on media is either is semi-fake or final fake or semi-truth or final truth. Am I talking to somebody here? So, I'm not causing hatred, but I want you to understand something, that we are in the world where you need to make spiritual inquiry of either who is leading you or who is following you or who is by your side or whom you are going together to a place. Whom you are going together with. You have to investigate how many men that are married witchcraft or no. And the woman enter into your house now, things start crumbling. Whose fault? Who shoots the man? Who shoots the woman for you? Your mouth. You saw the woman and said, I love you. And you open your mouth and said, I love wishes. Meaning that you love wolves. Because the Bible said, beware of them. And it said, be wise as a serpent. Can I talk to you? Serpents have a nature. When serpent is in this place, serpent never make noise. That is why anyone making noise about what God is doing for him or her, shake very well, they are fools. I'm sorry to say, but I have to say it. When God gives you glory, the glory is to edify the church, edify the nation, advertise the glory of God on earth, and let people know that God can do all things. Not for you to be going somewhere and now you create different kind of nonsense, intimidate people. Can I talk to you? There are some people, through the sources of another one, they have entered into trouble.
Yes, amen.
You don't know? There are some people on earth, for example now, come brother, maybe this brother genuinely, God bless him. And now this brother is a noise maker. Anywhere the brother wants to go, he needs attention. People must know he's there. People must know that he's going. Even the president of the country, they are crying to the media, please give me and my family privacy. I'm missing the truth here. So now God has blessed this man, and this man starts broadcasting everything, telling everyone. And now this brother come. Maybe this brother is the next door to this brother, and this brother married to a woman that cannot endure. I'm sorry, it's not all women that can endure. There are some women, when they see the success of their neighbor, they use it to criticize their husband. Can't you see that brother? Can't you see what he's doing to his wife? There are some women, men, if care is not taken, there are some women, if you start listening to their voice of frustration, whether you like it or not, you can put your hand into things that you don't want to put your hands to. And on the last day, God will never ask that. It's your wife that put you this. God will say, how now that you accept your wife? When Eve was deceived by the serpent, God asked the woman, why do you do this? But the first person that God laid curse on is a man. Why do you act into the voice of your wife? Have I not told you that it's only my voice you must act unto? And judgment was released. In fact, when you look at that scenario, you will know that Adam was not at fault. Adam was busy. Adam is not with Eve. But the only fault of Adam is that he did not make inquiry to know whom Eve is. Anytime your wife goes out and come in, make inquiry. How is the day? Ask, where are you coming from? What have you done today? Any spiritual interruption? Anyone that speak? Can I talk to you here? It may sound like a joke. They can use a common pamphlet to deceive your wife and launch you into occultism. They can use a common pamphlet to launch you. And your wife said, when I went out, I saw this flyer, and you know, because of our sovereign Hallelujah, and I thought if we can try this. And now you listen to the voice of the woman because of your sovereign Hallelujah, and you went there and you do what, before your eyes open, you are already an occultic man. Hear this: whenever you enter into occultism, it's easy to enter because there are some things they will hide from you. When you enter, your eyes will open, and to reverse, there will no way. So you have to be aware of men. If it is Peter, I said, Peter, come on, keep short. God said we should love everyone. If it's James, I said, James, it's because where you come from. Jesus that you follow said we should love everyone. But the same Jesus said, I say you should love everyone, but you must be careful, be aware of men. Be aware of men simply means be an attention. Be wise. Let your eyes open. So now, because of the weight of this one, the wife of this one intimidates him and does not know where this one got the weight from. And they now start seeking for solution. They start going from one place to the other. And before you know, when devil knew that you are looking for what he has, he introduced it to you. Because devil is looking for members. Yes, you don't know. Satan is looking for members. I'm still going there. We open your eyes to it. So now, the sources of this one intimidate this one to go on a wrong direction of his destiny fulfillment. By the time you will realize, damages might have been done. And that is why some of you here, before you realize that you have to come to Jesus, you have done a lot of damages because of your consultation with Sangomas. Anytime you visit either occultic altar or Sangoma altar, what they have is you shut one of your glory. Because he said that everyone have seen and come short. What is the glory of God? That is what God have created for you, your inheritance. Your inheritance. So the day that you consult a Sangoma, you have lost one glory. It may be a financial glory, it may be marital glory, it may be career glory, it may be business glory. But any day you visit Sangoma, you lost something. It is the Bible. I'm not talking to you here. So now, when the consequences of this one start coming, you will start saying, what is going on here? Where before, life is better, but now it's sour. Devil will never give you something without adding sorrow. The beginning will be sweet, but the end. Can I talk to you here? The one that approves your success will determine the end of your success. Anyone that approves your success will determine the end of the success. If it is the devil that approves your success, then devil will determine the end of your success. But if it is God that approves your success, then God will determine the end of your success. That is why Jeremiah 29 verse 11 said, the thought I have towards you is of good and not of evil, to give unto you expected end. Am I talking to somebody here? Am I talking to someone here? What make your foundation is the founder of your life. Can I talk to you here? Go and sit down. God bless you. Hear this. It is not all pastors that are reigning are genuine. Let me make this clear. Because the Bible says that which you hold, hold it fast that no man should take it from you. Am I talking to you here? And the same Jesus said, when you hear that they are mentioning my name there and say, Jesus is here, Jesus is here, Jesus, he said, don't go. Make a spiritual inquiry. Be aware of me. There is a place, there is a church where you enter, they initiate you or no. And to leave that place, you will never, even though you want to pull yourself out, you will begin to see that you will not be able. Something will just be forcing you to go there. We ask yourself, I don't like what they are doing. I don't like this. I don't like this. I have seen in my revelation that this man is an occultist. But to leave the place is difficult. Because of what you have been initiated. You have entered into covenant. Can I talk to you here? There are some pastors that God opened my eyes. This is not about ESA or somebody come and gossip to me. No. I saw it myself. God showed me. There are some pastors, they are occultic. Even in this land, South Africa. When I saw the revelation, I went. What is all this? And I saw people are under them. So simply means that the destiny of those people are under bondage. Somebody came to me and said, sir, is this right? My pastor said, even though you fornicate, it does not matter. I said, fornication will catapult your glory. Is Mike not here? Where is Mike? Ask Brother Mike. He met the person, our pastor Mike here. I said, when you fornicate, it increases your glory, it increases your blessing. He said, our pastor taught us. And members are under that church. Oh no, there are some people, they enter into that auditorium genuinely, innocently, thinking that this is a man of God. Am I talking to you here? Not every poster you see out there is genuine. There are some posters, they have soaked it with occultic powers. By the time your eyes see it, if you are not genuinely born again and you are not covered by the blood of Jesus, before you know, you will find yourself there. Am I telling someone here? Who pray for you, who lay hands on you, determine the kind of manifestation you manifest. So, church must be aware. In that revelation, revelation. God opened my eyes. I saw there are some pastors, they have gone to the river, and the power they are using is man-made power. Man-made power. Power from the ocean. And that is why you will see that they can never do 1 week without looking for a virgin. They use virgin to do what? To renew the power. Any pastor you see that is fornicating, there is something diabolic about the man. Because when they sleep with a virgin, that is when the power will increase, and that is when the crowd will increase. But I pray with the only anger in me, any pastor in this land of South Africa that is using occultic power, putting the destiny of people of God in bondage, oh heaven, hear the voice of your servant within the 24 hours before the end of this year. May they be exposed with shame. May they be exposed with shame. May they be exposed with shame. Sit down. Not all miracles are miracles. There are some miracles are demonic miracles, while some are divine miracles. Devil can do miracles. Don't be aware of this. Devil, look at the land of Egypt. When Moses dropped the staff, the staff became what? Snake. And when all the astrologers, they said, you don't know that we have also the same power. They do what? They drop their own staff. What happened? Snake. So don't let miracle move you. Don't let miracle move you. That pastor is too powerful. That pastor is too powerful. All powers are not powers. There are divine power and there are demonic power. Be aware of this as a church. You are coming to church every day, every night, every hour, every minute. It will be so shameful at the end when the trumpet shall sound and the master will say to you, I do not know you, you workers of iniquity. I'll be asking, Father, I use your name to pray. Yes, anybody can call my name. Everybody can call my name. My name is a free gift to every creation. But salvation that I have talking about is when you are genuinely washed by my blood and you are genuinely following me, not to follow a blind that show way to the blind.